Welcome back to gardening, and finally it warmed up a little bit in Georgia, so I'm here in my garden today thinking about adding some interesting features such as spheres or any globe style. So what I came up with is a couple of ideas that you can do is you can mold a mud bowl pretty much, and top it with moss. You can find moss in your garden shaded areas if you live in Georgia. If you don't live in Georgia and you don't have live moss, you can get it in any garden center. You might want to use some garden wire or floral tape to kind of hold the structure. And what I did is I added in the center of the bowl, I added some seeds of the flowers that I want. And for these particular ones, it's gonna be yellow poppy stick flowers, which is perennial too. And so that's one idea. I think it looks neat because it just, you know, it just looks not too busy. And this is fresh, that's why you kind of see bold spots. But later on, it's going to, like, in a season, in about maybe a month or two, it's going to fluff up a new growth of moss, and it's going to look nice. So moss is one of those easy growing plants, and it adds a little interesting character in your garden, kind of more like classy English style garden. And most importantly, it's like a topiary, like a globe look. So another thing that I was doing is this container that we have normally by the pool area, where I normally put like an arrangement of different flowers, and some of the, you know, dry leaves and dry petals, all the kind of stuff falls in a pool, and it's a concern for my husband who cleans the pool. Therefore, this year I want to try something different. I'm sorry, that's a neighbor's dog, if you can hear in the background. But anyways, so what I decided to do is to try create a bowl kind of dome shape and plant lemon lime sedum. Sedum also has that very beautiful feature of mounding. Like, it's going to be mounded. Just imagine this whole thing of lemon lime green sedum, and it's perfect for my zone. It's perennial, and so it can survive the heat, the cold, and also in the center I did put the yellow drumstick plant that is gonna shoot a stick and like have like yellow bowl flowers. So I will see hopefully how later to show you the progress on this. Now, if you want, I just did one planter of this sort, so I'm gonna show you how I did it with my second planter. So for those who really learn better or get better with seeing the actual step by step. All right, so what I'm gonna do first is remove this kind of, now when I look at this planter and I look at this planter, to me this is boring because it's kind of flat, right? Although you see what I was talking about mounting, yet like this lemon lime sedum, it just mounts like that and it's gonna be very dense. So what I'm gonna do, and this is my palm tree seedling, what I'm gonna do, I'm just gonna remove the whole thing first. And I may or may not use the same sedum depending, you know, we'll see. Because to stick, I need to have them a little longer. Okay. Since I'm already redoing the whole thing, I think what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna just replace the whole soil, because, you know, it's always a good idea to have a fresh soil for your new arrangements. So I'm just taking out the whole thing. Okay. make sure your drainage is working, it's not clogged. Okay, see how the big root was there. So drainage is important. So now what I'm doing is, if I do, and I tried it, if I do a bowl, if I make a bowl out of just the potting soil, it's not going to stick. So I went in my garden in the back and I dug out some dirt, like dirt, garden dirt. So what this is going to do is going to serve a purpose of a cement, kind of, to harden it off. And I already tried it out with that container and it did hold it all well. We had continuous rain for a few days and it did not fall apart, because my fear was that it will fall apart if it rains, because we do have some heavy rain times. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna mix up my dirt with the soil. So on the bottom I kind of still can put just the potting mix. This is a potting mix, okay? And on the top layer I'm gonna utilize more of the dirt, so it holds it well. But I still want my plants to get some nutrients, so I'm gonna definitely add some potting mix. So this potting mix is already wet. I need to see if it's sticking together. It sticks pretty well. I don't think I need it to be soaking wet. I think this is pretty good. So what I'm gonna do now is just the play time. Now I'm gonna mold my bowl. And I think I'm gonna need more. Okay, now we're just gonna press firmly, but also keep in mind that you want to make sure that the sides have room for water to settle. So I'm pressing it, yet I'm keeping that deep kind of pocket for the water when you water it and when it rains, so it doesn't overflow, kind of. Okay. Mix. Mix it all well. Okay, so I'm gonna use this sedum because I need a little leg space. The one that I took out from the planter, it kind of shallow, but it has roots, so I can just plant them somewhere else. Here I'm just gonna get some long ones with a little leg. You see these got leggy because I was covering my blue agave and it got a little bit protected.
but I think because of lack of sun, it got leggy. But that's okay, it's an easy plant, so I can just pull out like an inch or 2 inch long kind of cuttings and use them. But you see how this is what's gonna be like. This is mounting. It's gonna be so densely covered. These guys a little bit got cold because we had temperature in like 20s, but it will revitalize and come back, I'm sure. So I'm just gonna collect some and then we'll go back to our planter and plant them. Okay, so this is the plant that's gonna go in the middle. It's a yellow drumstick, botanical now Crossipedia. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna put a few of these seeds, and they're so tiny. In the center. Okay, and then I'm just gonna make holes for my sedum. As you do it, you will be cracking, but then pressing and cracking and pressing. I mean, you can obviously use a stick or something if you're very concerned about your manicure. I'm not. So now I'm just gonna put the lemon lime sedum inside. So just take literally this long, put them together neatly, stick them inside. Make sure there is no air, that's it. Two. The reason why it's two is in case if one doesn't work, the second one will. Although I do believe that both of them will work, but just in case, it's your insurance. So I'm just gonna do it in a fast motion so you guys don't have to waste your time on this.
All right, that was it for today. Thanks for watching this video, and I hope you find it interesting or inspiring. Get out and do something in your garden and share your ideas if you do have anything in regards to structures, interesting globes, or anything of that sort in your garden. Have a nice day. Bye.